The government say the new night quotas for Heathrow and Gatwick will improve life for the 2 million men, women and children who live in the shadow of the flight path. Gatwick night flights will be allowed to rise by 20% over 5 years, but noisy old jets will be replaced by quieter modern planes. Heathrow's night flights will be kept the same as now, with noisier planes slowly being phased out.
Local residents complain, though, that you're actually increasing the total number of flights at Gatwick. That's true, isn't it?
That is true, but they're going to be quieter aeroplanes. And at Luton, where they've had an experiment for some 4 years, they're so pleased with it, they're extending it, and I think they may well make it permanent. So, admittedly, it's a smaller number of flights around Luton, but I think residents around Gatwick ought to be assured that people who've tried this before have actually found it a great success.
Of course, there's no such thing as a quiet aircraft, and a quieter aircraft will always wake people up as it goes out at night or comes in at night, and we feel that, as we say, they have enough to put up with and they should have a night's sleep.
Can you guarantee that these new quieter planes won't actually wake people up at night?
Well, I can't guarantee that, but what I can do, and I've agreed, in order to meet the concerns of residents around Gatwick, to review this after 2 summer seasons, rather than the 5 years that was originally planned.
Windsor's Conservative MP has been campaigning for 16 years for a complete ban on Heathrow night flights.
I would like to have seen a complete abolition of night flights and them slotted into the daytime, irrespective of the commercial interests involved.
The extra planes start flying from Gatwick on April the 1st. The 2 million residents there and under Heathrow's flight path will then discover just how quiet the Transport Secretary's night jets really are. Simon Neave, Thames News.